And right now, I'm going to show you the world's easiest way to cut a bob, thanks to my girl. I didn't want to say your name wrong, so I put it right down in the caption. I will talk more about that later, but I didn't bump it or anything, straight out the pack. Right now, I'm going to do what she did. I'm going to take some hair that I'm going to leave out. Okay. I kind of go like right by my ear, I guess. That's the easiest way. Take a little more. Okay. So. Now I'm going to put in a ponytail. So about here. So about here. Okay. Next, so I won't be blind. Hold on. I'm very scared right now because this don't come out right. I don't know what I'm going to do. But we gonna pray. Okay. Put in a ponytail. I'm gonna start low because I'm scared, so like I said, I didn't bump it yet, so. So like she said, you have it in a ponytail. Okay. She put it up. Okay. She cut it upward. So that's what we're going to try to do. Okay, so we have this here. And it came out great. I'm so scared. Okay, so I'm gonna show y'all. See? That's exactly what I wanted, y'all. Exactly. Okay, so I'm gonna clean it up and bump it, and I'll be back.
Hey, y'all. So, okay, I am finished. It's like 5 in the morning. Like, no lies. Really late. So, I'm tired, and I know it's not perfect right now. But, it's gonna stay like this till in the morning. So,
here's the bob.
I mainly wanted to focus on the bob, not so much the front part, because y'all know I won't big miss up here, like, whatever. But just trying to focus on the bob. So, it's not really feathered. It's not feathered at all, actually. I'll probably feather this part, but none of this is feathered at all. This isn't feathered. It looks like it. It's not feathered. Nothing's feathered. Okay. So, this is it.
That's not you, patient.
You may not use two-way or three-way calling for this call to be disconnected. You are connected.
So I look like busted right now, but I didn't get a chance to razor my hair really when I did it because I was so tired. It was so late. So right now I'm just going to show you how
a razor cut my hair. I just raised it this side. That's why I look so flat. And y'all didn't bump this or anything. I just took my bonnet off. And this is how it happened to look. So, I usually use razors all the time. The reason I've been using scissors lately is because, I can work with scissors. You know, some people can't work with scissors, so they use razors. Scissors, I have a little more control, but razors, like, you cut, you done. But with scissors, I can kind of control what I'm trying to do. But since, for beginners, I prefer using a razor. You can use these to get from the beauty supply store for, like, $1.99. This is what it comes in. Hair trimmer by Annie. Or you can use an eyebrow razor. This will take you all freaking day. I hate these things, but first semester I was using them in my dorm because I didn't have my cutthroat razors. So I prefer using professional razors when doing eyebrows and doing haircuts. That's just me. So with the razor, I don't want it to be so thin. I got a string right here that's loose. See? Let me go ahead and cut this. Okay. So I don't want it to be real, real flat, but I want it to be flatter than it was in the previous video, okay? So all I'm going to do is look at where I'm trying to cut at, and I'm going to start with by getting my part straight, putting the hair on the side it needs to be on. Okay. Now, this side is fine. I don't mind this side being as high as it is, but I don't want this side to be so bulky. So, all you do is take your razor and just randomly cut.
This been a long time since my man been gone, but when he get here, you know I won't be gone, because I love him. I'm gonna love him strong.
Hey y'all, it's so funny how simple things make a huge difference in a hairstyle. I say this because it looks so much better. Like, y'all probably can't tell because on camera everything looks the same, but it looks so much better now because I actually finished it. Like, I razored, I thinned it out. Up in here, I thinned it out some. And over here, I thinned it out a lot. And then, as you can see, it's more thinned out. Right here, I just added about 4 tracks, a 12-inch, so I can get this length. And as you can see, it's more of a bob now. It wasn't really connecting to me before because I had so much hair at the top. And for it to stop, like, right here, it didn't look right to me. So all I did was add, like, 5 tracks. Of 12 inch about this wide, and I just placed it on top of a existing track in my head, so it's not on my edges, it's not glued straight on my hair, it's glued on top of another track that's already in my hair. So I just added that in so I can get a longer length, so it's kind of longer on this side and shorter on this side. I may go back again and cut this shorter so it can be like asymmetrical a little bit. So it'll be shorter over here and longer over here. And right up in here, I razored this like that. I just took the razor. I have a little razor thing I showed y'all. And I just razored this so it won't look as bulky right there. But for the most part, I don't want to make this flat. The reason why I leave my hair so bulky, and y'all wondering why, is because over the weeks, it gets flat. So, if it starts off big like this, I know it's going to look better or the same and like into the week. So, I don't have to worry about my hair looking so flat. Because sometimes I hate when people do their hair first, and then it's flat the first day. It's like, oh, what's gonna look like when it gets old, like a week later? It's gonna look super flat. So I'm gonna play with it before I take it out. So this is it. It's not bumped over here. It's just how I cut it. So this is the idea, and I love it. So thanks, Into Hair. Thanks a lot, because you help a sister out a lot. And
cut the music up in the headphones, please. As I give you
the business.
Cut the music up, please. And the headphones, please. Please. Hey, Miss Pauka. When you're not letting it fall, Miss Pauka.